I'm Rick. I'm alongside Josh Dipert. We're here at the Kingdom in Carlsbad, and we're looking at the new 2018 M3 irons. And Josh, I think if I had to ask you for three things to tell me about the new M3, I think you would say RIBCOR, RIBCOR, and RIBCOR. Am I wrong?
You're not wrong. Okay. That's correct. Exactly.
Can you tell me about it?
On the new M3 are the kind of lead technology, the what's really changed that kind of drove, create a new name is RIBCOR.
Okay.
So what RIBCOR is, a new kind of technology, a new geometry that stiffens the head, that adds kind of structure to the entire head.
Okay.
What that does is it decreases the amount of energy that's lost in hitting the ball. We want to use all that energy and use all that energy to increase ball speed.
Okay.
We don't want to lose it in moving the head and the head flopping around. So we create this RIBCOR. What it does is structure that stiffens up the head, creates, it saves the energy into the ball.
Okay, and obviously you can see that it's not visible in previous models, so it absolutely is something new added this year.
Exactly. What we find is by adding the face slots, creates a lot of flexibility in the head, creates a lot of flexibility out in the toe. What happens out by design? What happens is outside of that, there's not much, there's no energy out there. All the energy is in the middle of the face, in the middle of between the two face slots. So what we can do then, if there's no energy out there, let's use that and stiffen up so that the top line all along here doesn't flex at all. We don't want that moving, we just want the center of the face moving.
Okay.
So that's what RIBCOR gives us. By stiffening up the top lines, we're able to stiffen up this part of the head so that all your movement is now just in the center of your face, in between the face slots and the sole speed pocket.
So more stability for more energy transfer and for straighter off-center hits.
Exactly, right? So those are the two big things, is the longer and straighter, faster ball speed and straighter, and then the other big benefit is able just to make the overall club sound better.
Okay.
So what happens is, why does a high COR iron sound different than a muscle back? A muscle back is a very thick, kind of forged chunk of metal.
Right.
Right? So there's not a lot of movement. When the club hits the ball, there's not much movement in the head because it's so thick and solid. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to decrease the movement in overall the outside of the head and only have the movement in the center of the face.
When you thin the face, what effect does that have on sound?
So when you thin the face will move and it will create more sound. The badge on the back, we use a term we call viscoelastic dampening. Okay. What that means is it's a technical word for saying we use the badge to dampen out that sound. So the face, we only want the face to move.
Right.
Because the face moving creates ball speed. But we can get the face will move the one time, we just don't want it to vibrate for a long time. If it moves back and forth for a long time, it creates sound that doesn't sound good. So the badge dampens out that sound and creates a better sounding club.
Okay, so we got better sound, we got better distance, and better forgiveness.
Yes.
Who is the M3 player? What player is looking to play this iron?
Yeah, so the M3, who we designed this for, is a better player.
Okay. Right?
So it's not, this is not the bulk of the mark, the game improvement. This is a smaller head. It's a more workable head. What one of the things that allowed us to do this is we want to take all the technology and put it in a smaller package.
Okay.
The only way we were able to do that was the addition of tungsten.
Mm.
So tungsten allows us to have high MOI, low CG, but still in a small head.
Okay. So tungsten's very heavy.
Very heavy.
By putting it on the toe, you're just going to, when you talk about a higher MOI, just resistance to twisting.
Exactly.
Putting all that weight on the
exactly.
toe.
Exactly. So what you're trying to do is, when you put the tungsten in the toe, you're offsetting all that mass in the hosel.
In the hosel.
So you're creating a CG that's more centered as well.
Mm.
So a traditional iron would have a CG that's more toward the heel because of all this mass in the hosel. We want to try to get the CG, the center of gravity, right in the center of the score lines. That's where people line up a ball.
Sure.
That's where they hit. You want to get the maximum distance. You want to get the maximum speed. You want to hit right behind the center of gravity.
Right.
So that allows us to do this. The tungsten also allows us to have a narrower sole.
Okay.
So on the M4, you have a little bit wider sole because you have to put the mass somewhere. When you thin out the face, you thin out the top line, you thin out the hosel, you got to put the mass somewhere. You got to put the weight somewhere. And so on an M4, you get a little bit wider. On this one, on the M3, you put the tungsten in there. That is able to let you keep a smaller kind of profile, smaller sole width.
Okay, so a very forgiving club, but yet for a player that likes to work the ball, he's still going to have that benefit.
Exactly, exactly. And just the overall kind of smaller look, less offset, thinner top line, like you said, more workable sole.
Okay.
It's good. Who this is kind of designed for.
Yeah, excellent. Okay, that's the M3 iron for 2018 from TaylorMade. TGW.com does offer a 30-day mulligan policy, so feel free to try it out, and if you don't absolutely love it, you don't keep it. If you like the previous models of the M1, then I think you're really going to see and love the benefit of the technology in the M3.